talk about our accomplishments for FY14 for a goods in department in Swedesboro. So our top accomplishment for me was our put away percentage for the year. We're ranked number one in the network, 99.98%. So outstanding job by the team, great team effort. Our Dock to Stock, which we started on 9/16, we consolidated both shifts. John's going to talk about that.
Yeah, so September 16th, we implemented our 12-hour put-away SLA. We consolidated. We moved third shift to a staggered first shift. We cross-trained people, and we turned this into a Lean Sigma project because we figured that we saved about $50,000 between utilities, shift differential, etc. It's also a way to improve our quality. We're getting the product in the bins much faster. So we're now currently best in the network for our put away SLA. We have 12 hours and we do it in approximately 6 hours.
All right, Dan, you want to touch on our team accomplishments?
Sure thing, Tom. The goods in department saw a 40% productivity increase in FY14, which allowed us to not only hit our 12-hour SLA, but reach a lot of our goals as well. Like anything we do in the building, none of this would have been able to happen without the associates buying in and performing to the best of their ability. So right now we have a list of associates who averaged for the year over 100% productivity, and those associates are Michelle Ottinger, Steve Parkhill, Jim Higgins, Gina Sharp, Ben Spence, Brian Padgett, Ray Covington, Michael Horace, Darlene Coleman, Ken Small, Cheryl Daniels, and Ben Robinson. We wouldn't have been able to accomplish any of this without the associates producing at such a great level. In addition to the associates performing at over 100% average for the year, we also had numerous employees of the month. And the winners from the Goods Inn area were Jim Higgins, Darlene Coleman, Cheryl Daniels, Terry Patty, and Mike McConnell. So between the Goods Inn department, the replenishment department, and the config support department, our team's definitely going in the right direction.
Hello, team. Having a great time with my daughter. The time off that we are sharing. Just want to wish y'all continued success and luck. Continue to push forward. I'll see y'all when I return. Hope you do work.
Congratulate Dan and John on winning the Manager Achievement Award at FY14. Great job, guys. Couldn't have done it this without you.
Hi, welcome to the Integration Center. Let's talk about what the folks in integration have to hang their hat on for the last year. Alrighty, well, let's take a look at cost. For the last year, we saved over 16% of over budget, or about $194,000. So a great team effort with being flexible with their staffing. We also had a 28.9% gross profit increase in fees over costs. Not to be outdone also by the service levels provided by the team. We missed zero orders during the course of the year. We had a 7.5% increase in the unit shipped over what the forecast was, so great job by the team there. Okay, but most importantly, let's look at the people piece, because I really think that that's the backbone of what makes the Integration Center, as well as the Swedesboro facility, the success that we've had in the last year. For flexibility and support, many of my team members not only are flexible within the center, but have also helped outside of the integration room, helping with administrative support, quality auditing, new hire and annual training, as well as helping out in the goods in and goods out area. Special congratulations to two Exceptional Achievement Award winners for the past year. Both Tammy Gates and Phil Wallace were recipients of those awards and well-deserved. Not to be outdone, obviously, by Employee of the Month winners. The Integration Center awarded four Employee of the Month winners for the fiscal year 14. Phil Wallace, Benny Carter, Jazz Malik, and the newest winner, which is Mike Barr. He doesn't know. Quality was also exceptional during the year. We had zero non-conformities and findings in both our internal and our external audit. So great job by the team. So what are we looking forward to in fiscal year 15? A strong commitment to excellence goes without saying. I'm excited to say now that the TD Mobility team are on board with Tech Data. We've started to branch out into both the phone and tablet business, so that's some exciting news. Another exciting opportunity is our strengthening partnership with our Cisco team and the UCS B and C Series server business is expected to increase. But it goes without saying that really the dedication of the team and the hard work in improving our customer experience is paramount to the success of the center as well as, you know, the entire Swedesburg facility. It's really about winning one customer's one experience at a time. CX1, baby. Fiscal year 15. Great job. So I want to wish the Swedesburg team a great fiscal year 14 and happy new year for fiscal year 15.
This broadcast to bring you a special message. A turn of events is occurring all over the world. Several witnesses have claimed to see a
Congratulations, everybody. You achieved your shrink goal for FY14 with a shrink of 1.5 BPS. This amount is a savings of over $400,000 compared to FY13. You also had 3 out of 4 quarters where you achieved your shrink goal. Your mission for FY15, should you choose to accept it, is to build upon that success. You are to achieve a shrink goal for all 4 quarters, which has been lowered to 1.5 BPS from 1.6 BPS. You are to receive and move product correctly. You are also to pick, pack, and ship according to SOPs. Should you achieve these goals and have a shrink less than 1.5 BPS, there is an extreme likelihood that you will have no physical inventory this year. Congratulations again. Good luck to you on your new mission. This message will self-destruct in 5 seconds.
Okay, let's give your teams a round of applause. I think everyone did an outstanding job presenting the information, so thank you so much.
Good job.
So just want to introduce you to myself, Lenny, and I are, we're the Goods Out Management team, and we just want to take some time to reflect on some of the challenges, look at our accomplishments, as well as our goals for 2015. Well, Lenny's going to talk about our accomplishments, and I'm going to talk about our challenges.
Well, guys, we had a very busy end of the year, and I think we did exceptionally well considering we had a very new crew, a bunch of inexperienced folks. You guys pulled together, you learned your responsibilities, and really you knocked it out of the park at the end of the year. You had a new area manager, and we all were getting to know each other. I think we did an excellent job. We saw increases in productivity, we saw increases in accuracy. We just did an extremely good job handling the day-to-day basics. Our carriers are happy with our performance. They come and go on a regular schedule, and we've done a very good job, and I appreciate the effort that everyone has put in the Goods Out department.
Okay, thank you. And then I want to give you a holistic thing. Like, just to piggyback on some of the things that Lenny said, yes, it's been very challenging, and I believe we overcame those challenges. Again, a new management team, some new associates. We've converted a lot of folks to tech data, so our temp ratio has went down. And I'm looking forward to an exciting 2015. And I think for the most part, the world is ours, if I can put a coin that term. I think now that we have the key people in place, we'll be bringing in another manager for small partial. So we'll have a full management team for goods out for 2015. And we're looking to make sure we continue to build upon those successes that we had in 2014. So again, once again, thank you all for your hard work and your efforts for